See, after the compulsory exercises, United States and China and Japan, and in fact, Britain ended up in ninth.
She too takes quite a long step on landing, but it was a better controlled vault. There's the flight. Now she pushes off the hands. There's a second flight, and it's the one that comes from the contact with the apparatus, but that is an uncontrolled step forward. 9.6 though. It's quite a good score. Imagine what's going to happen when the Americans come later. And of course we've got the Romanians. Better. Just slightly out of her alignment, and it's 9.7. Just a tenth better. Say Watanabe. Third girl, who's 15. Oh, nice pre-flight, that really was. There was a lightness about that. And 9.7 has been given, and that... That's a problem, because it was a very much better vault than Oyagi, the girl who preceded her. Now, clearly the judges have got a problem, but they cannot hand that problem on to the gymnast. And again, it's a super vault. What are they going to do with it? We're here at Pauley Pavilion as the American girls get underway. Pamela Bielek, first to go on vault. And it's a cracker. What a reception they got as they came into this arena. And here's the first girl, generally the poorest on the squad, who starts off. And of course, the judges have a problem on the vault. They mark the Japanese girls incredibly high, and that's better than anything the Japanese girls did. Lovely flight. Lovely stretched extension. And a super landing. And she's already scored 9.75. Local Californian girl. And this is Mary Lou Retton. And there's been more written about this girl in the build-up to the Los Angeles Olympic Games than almost any other, certainly any other gymnast, and as much as any of the athletes. Mary Lou Retton. She really is a power pack. She's 4'9". Also from Houston, but she's a beautiful woman. Just popped up a little bit on landing. Also coached by Bella Caroli. She's like a little rubber ball. All the Americans favor her for the individual all-around gold medal at the end of these games. And the two competitors that will be against her are Agaki and Szabo from Romania. Oh, she's got a 9.9 for a first effort. I was saying that she's got Agaki and Szabo from Romania, both of them earlier coached by Caroli. So Caroli will have mixed interests here, the man who defected from Romania. This is a recording of her routine. Whoops of delight. It is a good routine. And she flies away, and she has a big, big smile. And she scores 9.85. Now Kathy Johnson. First came to prominence by winning the 1977 American Cup. Now 24. The only married member of the American team. She scored very well indeed. A 9.85 on vault, 9.6 on bars, and that's another good performance. And they wait, as many a gymnast has waited this morning. And of course it's the Americans that set the standard, and she's got a 9.85. Use her gum, Kathy Johnson, high scorer to date, Ombi, but Julianne McNamara follows her. Julianne, 18, from Houston, Texas. This is the girl who joined Bella Caroli, the man who coached Nadia Comaneci, joined him earlier this year. American girl in world championship. She finished seventh in 1981. Superscore matches Kathy Johnson. Well, if there was an official pixie to the Los Angeles Olympic Games, this would be it. Mary Lou Retton, 16, born in a small town in West Virginia, where she was the toughest kid on the block, boys included. Moved on to Houston, coached by Bella Caroli.